I want to see theory play.
All right, and they actually did get the team names in and correct
all
this
right.
time.
It'll be the one guy with an assault rifle, too.
Yeah, well, they might. Let's see what they run here. We have
yeah,
two
vectors
and three vectors and the
Remington.
One Remington here. So
at that thermal.
Yes, you know, we'll see. You know, we're back to thinking back to G3. We saw them absolutely crush. It was Swanee. He would run that M3 with the thermal, or the Remington with the thermal, and no one was willing to run Inca, and he was just absolutely crushing here. But I'll switch off because Theory is going to be the one to wait back at the base. And I know we had to fill a little bit while we waited, so we're going to go ahead and give you guys a treat off the break here. We're going to hop into a listen-in with TK.
I'm going to bust.
I got broken.
You spawned strip, Brandon?
Yeah.
He's bus, bus, two. There's two, there's two. There's two mid alley.
I got them both. One time bus. They're all broken. I'm going top one.
Alright, I'm in.
Don't flip out. Someone just threw a stun at me. He's stunned in the back over here.
One's front broken Humvee. He's sitting at front broken Humvee.
I got underpass Nesto. He went core.
He's still laying down mid Humvee.
I got double nade. I got double nade. Watch mid alley.
Good mid alley. I'm trying to run back to C. I spawned ship.
Don't worry about it.
I got C.
Good, I'm gonna have
I'm nading over there.
One shot. All right, they're gonna be on bottom of top. They're gonna be on mid alley, bottom of top.
All right, and we're back. Fantastic communication there out of TK. Nezla was finally able to get that B cap as well as get set up on here on this neutral. He might even be able to scare. Now, the nades are going to fly in. He did get the neutral off of A, so all the points going to be going to TK currently.
Let's go over and spectate Revenge. I want to see what it looks like from their point of view. Been kind of TK heavy. Let's give these open bracket guys some love. We're watching Skill here. Skill Revenge. It looks like he's going to take a more conservative right around. Kind of worried about getting picked off, so we're going to go through the building and try and keep TK off of A.
Yeah, he's got to get something done because they're about to get three capped, and that was a nice kill there. I believe out of Sharp there to clean that up. So the three cap is on. The lead is going to continue to increase. I want to hop to a listen in here with Revenge. It just came out of the open bracket. Just see how they're going to bounce out of this three cap.
Sharp. He's like causing stairs. He's like left stairs.
He's still here. He went impossible.
One's gas. I'm going through closet.
It's impossible still.
Top on.
Yeah, he's closet out. It's Sharp. It's Sharp. He's roaming. We got another player here. Nice. That's three dead. Last guy's Theory. And Nezla's off spawn.
One was on the bus.
Go for C if you can.
He's underpass. He's bottom of the
We got to get a player.
We got a player.
I got him.
Nice.
I got it.
I'm going C.
Fridge.
I'm hopping C right now.
I got one.
I'm going closet. Trying to help LA.
I got him.
One's down here. There's one back one. Back one. Pawn 18. Back pawn to C.
I'm stunned. He's on it. It's Nezlo.
Stop on B.
Hop on.
Prep broken.
Gas sign.
Try and step for a sec.
I got
slay. Good job. Watch your broken.
Oh, you should stay on though.
I got him.
No, I thought you were pushing both.
Hop on again.
One more gas. He's sub. He's pushing. Big win, dude.
Watch your back.
Gas again.
I killed him. Nice. Keep watching that. Push our right back.
I'm broken. I'm top broken.
There's going to be two more probably.
All right. Hopping back in this one. 60 seconds left. TK crushing right now. They had Revenge locked in that three cap for so long. And what are they up? 35 points right now.
It's not looking good for Revenge right now. Even if Revenge comes back and gets some points at the end of this round, they're going to start the next round massively down, and they're going to have to make a pretty astonishing comeback to come out and win this domination match here. Let's see what Nelso's up to.
Yeah, Nesli, a nice grenade there on the Humvee. Gonna push it here. He's been leading his squad 13-9 right now. Make it 14-9. Two caps as well. As a player to his left, wisely backs down. He's gonna actually challenge here. Able to pick up the kill. Great job by Nesli. Time winding down. Lead still in around 30 points. TK is being two capped right now, but honestly, as big of a lead as they got through the mid map of this one, they can give up these few points here.
Nesli is just going for kills here. I think he wants his specialist streak.
Yeah, he's crushing right now, and Goon able to pick up that one, but Nesli doing it all. He's going to cap B at the last second here. Basically a 2-1 ratio right now, and that first half was all Nesli and all TK.
You can definitely see the skill gap there between the professional players and the open bracket players.
Yeah, they certainly locked that down, and they held. Yeah, I didn't see exactly how long the three cap was held, but they did an excellent job.
It was long enough to put them almost 40 points.
Yeah, no, that's really where all their points came from, because the start of that game, the first minute or two, no one was even able to cap B. I don't think they got that until about 90 seconds into the match. It was just a lot of trading.
B's a dangerous place anyway. You got entry points into both sides, and it's very easy to chunk a grenade in the top, especially when if you're like these guys.
Yeah.
You spend 8, 9, 10 hours a day practicing throwing grenades into little holes you don't miss very often.
Well, I'm going to stick on with Slumber here. He's one I've heard been tearing it up during the open bracket. Golden Boy was praising him before this match. He is going to be running the Remington. He's got a player there, bottom pond. You can also see one underneath coming outside of A. No one really able to put pressure on B yet, but Slumber's going to have to deal with some of the head glitch, and he will get ripped apart there by Goon, who I will switch on with, who is in a power spot right now.
Yes, they do call it. Well, back when we had the M8A1, they called him the one-shot Goonjar, because he is deadly, deadly with assault rifles.
Yeah, he is one of the most accurate assault rifles in the game.
He's just waiting for somebody to show up top pond. He's going to pop them if they show up there.
Well, here's going to be the first engagement in and around B, and that's going to be Flexer, who is set up here trying to get nades. He's going to need cover from his team. He did get the trophy system down. He's able to get one kill with his grenade, pick up the second on Nesli there. I think it was actually his teammate that covered him, so very well done. They do have the two-cap control. They're pushing the three-cap. Who is that? That's going to be skill right now, but nades come in there from Goon and Theory, and they are going to drop.
TK's not going to let him three-cap.
Well, right now, at least, they have the two-cap with A neutral. They're going to be able to catch up here pretty quickly. I mean, a couple ticks here, and they're going to be right back in it. Just under 4 minutes to play. The lead is down to 15. Slumber is now pushing this three-cap, and they're forcing that strip spawn. With them to keep, they split. They need to push out together and try to push something on B. He's going to have a big gunfight here. If he can win that, this will lock down A. Great job by Slumber.
Let's move back over to TK. Let's see how they're doing on this side of the comeback.
Well, Nesli is very close to getting B, but he's getting pushed by really the entire squad there. Switching to Theory, he's able to clean up one before he drops. Two down for either side right now, Drifter.
Well, we're on the Sharp almost joke there. I wasn't expecting you to hand me off, but Sharp is, like I said, Sharp is about as pro and seasoned as they get. He's not going to give up easily. He's not going to let an open bracket team come back and throw him down. So he's, never mind. Sharp actually might just get grenaded by Slumber.
Well, Goon's going to have a lot of work cut out for him. He all picks one off, and the grenade gets as well. There's the three-piece for Goon. Three down right now for Revenge. Huge plays out of Goonjar, but they are still getting two-cap. We have a lead change here. Revenge coming out of the open bracket has now taken over this game one here against TK. Just about to hit the halfway point this side, too. I like the play out of Sharp here, pushing the home cap, trying to get a bit of a split. We have three down for Revenge again.
Trying to make sure nobody's too close before he hops on that flag. Going to go prone right underneath the trophy system. They always do that. They go prone underneath, kind of hoping that they'll shoot the trophy system and not them. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Well, he got the pre-fire off there, but not able to win the gunfight. Switching back on the Sharp, able to pick up 1 minute. He's the last alive right now for TK, though.
Revenge coming back. This is getting serious. I like this.
Well, Slumber, the one I heard great things about, he's 21-17, six caps right now, leading everyone from that standpoint, but that's four down, up to TK now to take over mid-map.
Well, Theory's on B, so we're looking good for that. Ooh, what's he doing? Swapping to the thermal, got shots in, can't finish, unfortunately.
Big thing there, though, he was able to
hit me. Right through the tree, did you see that?
Him through the palm tree there. Nice shots out of Theory after the rough start. But as we get down, under two to go, they still need to get back in control of this one. They do have two caps. They're still down a bit. They're forcing the strip spawn right now. I want to switch over and see how they decide to play out of this. Looks like they're going to be forcing towards A and then out towards mid-map here. Let's see. Nesli set up here on Humvee, watching anyone coming right side, able to pick off one. There's going to be a couple more coming across mid-map. He has eyes on two. That nade might connect for him. Doesn't even get hit markers. But Drifter, what do you think they need to do? We're tied up here with 80 seconds left to play.
I think TK needs to come out and play really, really hard. Well, they're literally tied. It might as well just the last couple of minutes might not have even happened. Both teams need to go big or go home. At this point, I would be playing hyper-aggressive. I would be flipping spawns. I would be pushing. I would be anybody that's a slayer. I would just tell them to slay as much as humanly possible.
Well, this is crazy because, yeah, there's C and A control. It's all tied up. B hasn't been taken.
Neutral.
So if no
we could actually see a tie here. We're going to watch very carefully. I think one of these timers might tick slightly faster than the other, and that'll determine the winner.
Looks like they did tick at the same time. Goon, that's going to be the play of the game right there. As Goon can get B, they're forcing that strip spawn again. He's in a great spot to pick up one kill. There was a second player there. Goon here has kind of been the man of the match.
We go.
He's got two more
TK
in front of him.
TK triple cap. That's probably going to lock them down. Yeah. Not unless they come back and just slaughter everybody and grab all the points, which is not very probable.
And Goon shooting bodies here. He's got the third coming backside, able to pick that up, running out of ammo with 20 seconds left on the clock. But Goon and crew have iced this one.
Yep, that's going to be game. That's just now they're just going for kills. They're trying to boost those stats, trying to look good.
Well, fantastic effort. I mean, from a cap standpoint, everyone on the board for TK. Goon breaking that 30-point mark. Yeah. Neslo just on its heels.
But look at Slumber, though. Slumber's got six caps.
Yeah, no, Slumber had a heck of a game. He was the one to look out for. But what was a tie game with, 60 seconds left? Ends up being a 24-point win for TK.
Good shit, bro. Way to step up. Goon.
You can hear a little bit from them there. They're sounding pumped up. Just looking over to the guys from Revenge, though. Talking it over as a team, seeing what they need to do differently. And to be honest, I haven't seen a lot of S&D out of Revenge. Obviously, TK, even back to the Black Ops 2 days, known to be a dominant S&D team.
Well, S&D is a place that I would say an open bracket team would have the, or like Revenge would have the best opportunity. That this is even what happens with EG sometimes. They play a team that they're not used to playing. They have unusual strategies, and you can really do weird things in Search and Destroy. Just like COD Champs, these Australian teams came out really, really hard in Search and Destroy because they weren't playing objective. They were just killing everybody really fast. So TK has no experience playing against them. They have no idea what their Search and Destroy strategy is going to be like. But I can guarantee you these guys have watched the TK streams, and they know what they're going to do. So this is the one that Revenge has the best chance of winning.
It can certainly, like you said, work to be an advantage sometime as the amateur team just because, you know, these guys play each other in the league all the time, the pros, and they're more familiar with the strats, whereas coming from the open bracket, not always as familiar with these play styles. But we are going to be hopping into Freight S&D next. Just a quick commercial break, and we'll be bringing you game two. Stay tuned.